Jeff, you ready? National Committeeman Jeff Johnson and Henry County Commissioner.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you for giving me a quick minute or two. And thank you for everything you do as activists. Those of us who are in elective office really do understand that we wouldn't be there if not for all the work you guys do. So we appreciate it. I also want to thank you for giving me the honor of serving you on the Republican National Committee. I truly do appreciate that. There are a lot of things I could share as an update. In particular, some of you know this report, the Growth and Opportunity Project, came out a couple days ago. I encourage you to go on the RNC website, rnc.com, I believe, and read through it. There's some really good things in there. There are some things I don't agree with in there, and I'm sure you'll share that. But look at it. Take a look. I think the important thing is we are looking inward to try to figure out how to make ourselves better as a party. The one thing, though, that I do just want to touch on very briefly regarding the RNC has to do with the rules, simply because I hear that from a lot of activists around the state. And some of you know there were some rules passed at last year's national convention that some of us don't agree with. We believe they're kind of contrary to what many of us think the party should be, a grassroots party as opposed to a top-down party. And I've been part of a group on the RNC that have been working to reverse a couple of those rules. We are likely going to get our opportunity to do that, to actually have a vote on that on the RNC to reverse a couple of those rules at our April meeting in California. I can't tell you how that's going to go. I can tell you that we're going to give it our best, most aggressive shot, but I'm not sure what the outcome will be. What I can say is this: if we succeed and get those rules reversed, then I think we as Minnesota Republicans ought to come home and celebrate for a day and then move on, not look back and start thinking about 2014. On the flip side of that, if we don't succeed, if we can't convince a majority of our colleagues on the RNC to reverse those rules, then we as Minnesota Republicans ought to come home and bang our head against a wall for a day, and then move on. Because I think if we really fixate on what separates us, or if we fixate on those things that other Republicans have done in the past that just really tick us off, and there's lots of them, if we do that, then we're really going to miss a golden opportunity in 2014. And it really is going to be a great opportunity, because next November, Minnesotans are going to have had 2 years to see what liberal leadership really is. Not what they were told it was going to be, but what most of us in the room knew it was going to be, just an absolute unmitigated Looney Tunes disaster. And we're going to be able to say to voters next year, hey, if you love massive tax increases, not just on those nasty wealthy people who make $150,000, but on everything that you purchase or eat or drink or think about or dream about, whether it's haircuts or ATM fees, those things are all still on the table, even if Dayton isn't backing them. Or snack food now, they're talking about a snack food tax, or liquor. Anybody remember the great government shutdown of 2011 that was supposed to end the world, but no one really noticed? Do you remember that? Do you remember what it was that turned everybody against the shutdown? Beer, yeah, it was beer. For whatever reason, Miller Brewing Company came out and said, because of the shutdown, we're not going to be able to restock the shelves, and all hell broke loose in Minnesota. So if you love the idea of a 300% increase on the liquor tax, or if you like this health insurance exchange concept that's going to cost $60 million but greatly limit your choices as a consumer, or if you just cherish the fact that government's going to have more and more control over your life day after day, then stick with these guys, because now you know that's what you're going to get. But on the flip side of that, if you happen to think that money is generally better spent by the people who earn it rather than by bureaucrats or politicians, or if you think that you and your doctor ought to be making healthcare decisions as opposed to insurance companies, or if you believe that rather than extending government into the free market, we ought to be extending the free market into government, then give us a try, because maybe you'll like what you see this time. And I recognize the last year for Republicans in Minnesota have not been, the last couple of years have not really been all that great. And I could go through the litany, but you all know what the problems have been. But I'm still optimistic, because we as Republicans tend to recognize when we screw up, and we learn from our mistakes, and we try to fix things. And that's what I'm seeing happening all over the state from every corner of our party, people trying to fix what's wrong with the party. And our problems aren't fixed, but the key is they're fixable. And that, I think, makes us very different from the Democrats, because they've got their share of problems, but two of them kind of tower above all the rest, Mark Dayton and Al Franken, and they are not fixable problems. They are stuck with those two no matter what. So let's let's not blow this golden opportunity. Let's put all the garbage of the last couple of years behind us, and let's really work together to present Minnesotans with a very bold, conservative, but positive choice. And I think if we give them that choice, we'll not only be able to send Dayton and Franken packing, but we'll be able to send some of these cartoon characters from St. Paul packing, and maybe once and for all, you'll be able to get rid of this woman named, what's her name again here? You can get rid of her once and for all as well. So thank you again for everything you do. I really appreciate it.